It's Stacey Jackson, and you are watching me live today. I am so excited about today's guest. I'm always excited about my guests, but today in particular, I have a really, really, really special guest. Now, you know how my dance music lives in the clubs and in the fitness studios, and people love to work out to it. But there was one thing that I found out this year that my record Live It Up with Snoop Dogg was being requested in the strip clubs. I know, it's incredible. And a lot of the girls were asking to dance to it, and it's been fantastic. So I received the most unbelievable dance that you might have seen already on my feed by this incredible award-winning pole dancer. And I hope that I'm gonna invite her in 1 second. I want to introduce her. Her name is Ms. Parker, but I have to say she has got a list of accolades as long as my arms. I mean, from at least 2017 up till now. I'm gonna read this because it's impossible to know off by heart. She has won Showgirl of the Year, Miss Exotic United States Master Dancer, Miss Exotic United States 2017, 2018. She's Stripper Olympics Champion. Hello. I can't even, the list is goes on. Golden G-String Invitational Champion. Oh my God. Anyway, I'm going to introduce the beautiful Ms. Parker, who, and we have a lot to chat about. So I have to invite you. Let me see if I can do this. This is where I always get like freaked out because I need to invite her. So let me press the button here. Nope, that's not that. Request to join. Let's see. Invite to join. Where is Ms. Parker? Are you there? There you are. Are you there, gorgeous? Let's see. Did you get my invitation? Did you accept?
Hello. Hi, how are you?
I am so happy that you've agreed to chat to me, because I mean, first of all, it's probably only 2 o'clock in the afternoon where you are, right?
Yes it is.
Okay. where are you originally from?
Oh, hold on, let me set you up here. I am located in Michigan in the U.S.
Okay, so you're 6 hours behind me, I think.
Yeah.
So it's 1 o'clock in the afternoon there, I think. Okay. First of all, when you sent through that dance, and I cannot believe how many views I've got. I mean, like in the first 10 minutes, it went crazy. You have also performed with unbelievable musical artists like Benny Benassi, 50 Cent, Dylan Francis, Lil Dicky, Blase. I mean, so you've been on tour. You get the whole craziness of traveling and being away from your family and juggling, you know. So let's start first with, how the heck did you get into pole dancing? Like, were you a kid and go, oh my God, I want to be a pole dancer? Did you see someone that just inspired you? Like, how did it start?
Well, technically, I have been dancing since the age of 3. I haven't been doing pole since then, but I was in tap, ballet, jazz, gymnastics. So dance has always been a part of my background. Fresh out of high school, I was a single mom. I had my first son when I was 17. So I needed a job with cash, like now. I went into the strip club industry and I didn't know nothing about pole. I happened to see one girl, she completely blew my mind. And I was like, that's a wrap. That is going to be my goal. I want to be able to push my body as hard as I can and do all the pole tricks. And one day I want to be the headliner. And it took some time, but now I have made that goal become a reality for myself.
It's beyond reality. I mean, I can't even, I'm like looking at the list of awards that you have. It's insane. And I mean, you've also done like Ozfest. I mean, so you're obviously in high demand to do what you do. What you do takes the most incredible amount of fitness. I mean, I don't know how you do. I can barely pull myself up. I mean, I push myself to do 5 chin-ups. I don't know how you hang horizontally from the pole like a flag. And I mean, how much training does that take? It's just incredible to watch.
I try and train as much as possible, but my youngest child is 2, and when you have a toddler around the house, it makes things incredibly difficult. So I don't get to train as much as I would like, normally 3 days out of the week. And a lot of that time when I am able to train, it's when I'm performing at my shows.
So you actually are training for the show.
Yeah, so I'm able to, I try and put in at least 20 minutes a day, whether it's stretching, some sort of minimal weightlifting. As you can see, I have my pole in my house. So I'm, you know, do a spin or two around it as often as possible. But to do the consecutive, you know, 2 hours worth of training that I would like to put in, that's mainly on the weekends.
It's incredible. I mean, it's absolutely incredible. So you were saying you have young family. So how do you juggle this? Like, I mean, I know that with my job and what I do, and there was a lot of touring involved and everything, like having the support of my family was super important. Like my mother would fly over and my husband was there. And like, I really, but you're a single mummy. So like, how did you manage? I mean, you would work obviously late at night in the club. So how do you balance that?
Well, we have 50-50 split custody of my children. So during the week I have them, that's when I'm home, that's when I'm mom. And then when the children go off to their father's house, Thursday afternoon, I'm off to the airport, I'm gone, and I'm working all weekend long. Thursdays and Sundays are normally my 24 to 30 hour days. Because not only am I traveling, but then I also, once I get there, I check in, change hair and makeup, and go straight into performing. So,
when do you sleep?
Team no sleep.
Because your costumes are incredible. So, do you ever do it topless, or you're always dressed, or do you?
It depends on the venue that I'm performing at. If I'm doing a music festival concert, obviously we are not able to get topless or anything like that. Majority of my performances are inside of gentlemen's clubs. So depending on the jurisdiction and the rules inside the club, I could be topless or fully nude, or sometimes we're not able to get topless, so we wear pasties. So it depends on where I'm sent.
I mean, if it were me, babe, I mean, they'd be flying all over the place. I'd get black eyes swirling around that thing. I mean, I don't know how you do that. I mean, unbelievable. So you must have to deal with some over exuberant fans, obviously, given your vocation. So did you ever get into a situation where it was like scary for you? Like, you know, cause this is like what you do is, it's a high risk, obviously, as a woman to be doing what you do. So how do you manage that? Do you have someone that like always is with you, like a security guard, or how do you?
Not
do you know karate?
I wear 8-inch heels, so that.
Yes. I want to see you twirl around. Will you give me like a 5-second little spiel around? Can you do that for me, or is it, are you all dressed and not really feeling going on the pole right now?
You know what? Hold on. Let me move it. Let me grab my.
Literally just like a swirl around, just because a lot of people have seen obviously the video, but this is crazy. When I watched it, my jaw was like on the floor. So I mean. Look at this. This is an award-winning pole dancer who, I swear, like, watch this. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Look at this. Holy cow. How do you do this? I can't. You are. Wow. Yay. Oh, my God. Everybody who's watching is probably going, holy cannoli. Honestly, that is just sensational. And you do it so gracefully also. What I love about it is, especially with Live It Up, when you sent your video through, I was just, my jaw was on the floor. I mean, because you just have such grace when you do it. You know, your choreography is incredible. So,
thank you so much.
You're so cute, honestly. And then we put together, you had all these different outfits. So how do you choose your outfits? Is that also basically, you know, venue inspired, or, you know, do you go shopping for these sorts of things, or do they say this is what you need to wear?
So the two outfits that I picked when I did the Live It Up video were just my normal, like if I were to house dance or perform at a venue, everything has to be covered. So that's what I wore. Now, when I go into the gentlemen's clubs, I'm in a completely different outfit that normally has five different pieces to it. My one award-winning show, well, I have a few of them, but my one that has been three times award-winning now is my Cruella de Vil show. So, I mean, I have the wig, the gloves, the flashy dress. It's all sequin made. I do have a professional costume designer, so all of my costumes that I do wear are made to fit me. So there's quite a bit that goes into it. But yes,
was there ever what's your best experience doing what you do? And then what's your worst or your most scariest? Like, you know, like somebody just asked me this question actually about my career. And I mean, there's so many highs, you know, in what we do, especially as women doing what we love, you know? So there, for me, there are plenty of highs. So what are the best experiences out of this for you? Obviously winning awards and all that, it must be like top of the moon, right? And then what's your most scariest or most worst experience?
My best experiences are when I go into a club and all the house dancers, which are the normal entertainers that work there, that they're all excited to see me and meet me. And, oh my gosh, I look up to you. That really makes my heart smile because I'm always invading their territory. I'm brought in to be the headliner and I'm always afraid like that they're not going to be so welcoming of me because I am taken away from them because a lot of fans come in to see me in my shows. But when they're just as giddy as the guys that come in to see me, that makes me really happy. And that makes me know that I'm doing a good job. That's especially great. When I have a lot of female fans too. That makes me really happy.
Them.
Thank you. Because in my line of work, you would think I would have a majority male base, fan base.
Yeah.
And
when
how many women follow me and, you know, I get a lot of, you know, heartfelt messages from women, that means a lot to me too. Because of course, guys be like a pretty face. But when women message you, they're like, oh my gosh, what you do and you're a mom and this and that. That means a lot to me, and that just pushes me even harder to be better because I get all these messages that seriously, a lot of them make me cry in a good way.
I'm sure. It's so nice to hear that. I really understand that. I think that if you're out there inspiring people, there's nothing better, honestly. I mean, do your kids know what you do or understand what you do? Or like, what is their, you know, how do they not handle it? I mean, because obviously this is what your career is, but like, you know, as youngsters, what are their take on this? Do they, you know, at what level are they understanding what you do?
So my oldest is about to be 16 and he knows 100% what I do. He has no issue with it because when I was offered to start touring as a feature entertainer, I asked him his permission, basically. I said, listen, mom is going to be touring the country as like a famous super stripper. I will, you know, he is involved, but I'm performing I'm performing. I'm not just getting up there, hey, you know, I'm like, there's a lot more to it. I said, if this is going to be something that's going to be hard for you, maybe, you know, you might get bullied in school for it. I said, I won't do it. You know, I want to know how you feel. And he's like, no, mom, I know how you operate. You're a professional. This is something you want to do. Go for it. So that meant a lot to me too. I asked my oldest son at that point in time, and he's very mature for his age. So he blessed me with that. My 9-year-old, I think he might be coming to terms with what I do, but he knows that I perform. He knows every weekend I'm gone. He sees all my costumes. He thinks they're really cool. He likes to play with my props. He knows that I've worked with some, you know, famous music artists. He tells me, he's like, mom, you're famous. I'm like, no, not really, but that's cute.
I think that what you do is so remarkable, and you're, you know, it's like with any job. I mean, look, there are actors who have to do kissing scenes or love scenes with another actor, and they're happily married to someone else and have children. But by definition, they're like, you know, in the middle of a hot and heavy sex scene. And so their children have to sort of respect that that's what their mummy does. And they're an actor, and they separate their life from being the that performer. It's a role that you play from the mummy or the wife or the girlfriend or whatever. You know, as a professional, that's what you or we have to do in order to be able to like do our job really well. Because if there is that in the back of your mind that, ooh, you know, what are my kids gonna think? I mean, because even for me, you know, I have like little hot pants I'll be performing, and I have some costumes that my kids have also, you know, kind of put the big question mark on, like, Mom, really? You need to wear those sequin hot pants again? I mean, you know what I mean? So, and I'm a lot older than you. This is probably worse. But so I completely get it. But it's great that your kids are so mature about it and are sort of, and they're great. I mean, that's what they have, you know, I guess what they have to do. But you have a 2-year-old also, I guess. Is that a boy or a girl? You have 3 boys or?
Boys, yes.
3 boys. Okay. Well, you've got your group of security guards there for sure. So you're going to be okay, girl. So, and on that note, was there any ever something that had ever freaked you out or so scary or something so bad that you were like, oh my God, why am I doing this? Or was there ever anything like that you that really made you worry?
No, thankfully I haven't come across a situation like that. Thankfully, knock on wood. Yeah. Everyone has been pretty respectable of me. I think it's the way I present myself. I'm very flirty with how I am, but I don't go over the top with that.
Right.
And I am a mom first. So okay. I'm a entertainer second, and I think a lot of people respect that in a way. So
100%. I mean, that's why I wanted to have you on the live. I think you're so inspirational. And so what is the dream for you? I think you're at your dream. I think you are living your dream. That's important. And is there anything else above this goal, or is there, what else is on the Ms. Parker agenda? Like, is there something you want to share with us? Like, tell me your ultimate, or what the next steps are for you.
So there is, in the industry every year, there is Entertainer of the Year, ED's Entertainer of the Year. That's Exotic Dancer. And mm-hmm. I love to win that one day. There's a big, huge competition, the EDIs, Exotic Dancer Invitationals, which they're coming up in April and May. They're split into 2 divisions, East Coast, West Coast. The winner of East, the winner of West, they battle it out along with a third who is mainly like an online vote-in. And so there will be 3 people that are up for the nomination. Okay. And I would love to win ED's Entertainer of the Year.
Well, how do we vote?
There will be a link that you can go online and vote. So it does boil down to being like a popularity contest when it does come to the final nominations.
Well, after what I just saw on that poll and that whole, for me, hands down, you are the winner. Oh. Okay. So send me that link and I'll get some of my fans to vote also, because honestly, I'm super inspired by you, and I'm so grateful that you took the 20 minutes to talk to me today. And is there anything else you want to add? Because I'm going to wrap this up now, but honestly, I really, really thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for taking the time today. I know you're busy juggling the kids and then, you know, all that. And it's a weekend, so you're probably off going to perform this weekend. Or do you have a show?
I do not have a show this weekend. I have weekends off, so I'm just kind of working locally.
Thanksgiving.
But after this, I'm going to be on the road, super busy and preparing for EDIs, like I mentioned. I want to thank you so much for giving me this opportunity.
Oh, don't be silly.
You are amazing. You are phenomenal. And I really love your song, Live It Up. That was so much fun.
Thank you. That means, it really means a lot to me. Because like, like I when I introduced you, it's true. My club, my songs live very lovely in the clubs. This is where the, you know, the dance music, and of course in the fitness world. But then when I heard that the girls were, you know, stripping to it, I'm like, really? That's amazing. It's for me, I, you know, just that to have love is great. And thank you so much. And stay in touch, please. I'll send you a link for this if you want to put it on your feed as well. And yeah, please stay in touch. Big kisses from across the pond. And maybe one day I'll actually come and see you perform. That would be awesome.
That would be great if we
could. I'd love that. I really would. Take care and goodbye, everybody. Thank you all for joining me and the beautiful Ms. Parker today on Stacey Jackson Live. Bye. I have to press the X. I have to remember to press the X. Okay, X is going. Okay. Where are we? Like Stacey's video. Am I off? I think I'm off. I don't know if I'm still. No, I think I'm still live. Let's just work. X. Are you sure that you want to end your live video?